How is this project different than other projects you've done in science classes or?
It's different because it's, for me, more interesting and fun.
I think the best part was messing around to get all the ideas together. It was really fun trying to like figure out what would work best.
We don't usually get to do this. Like, we don't usually get to create.
Here at the New York Hall of Science, we are very interested in the design process. Along with developing an exhibition for the museum called the Design Lab, we're also working with teachers to help bring design into the classroom. In the summer of 2011, we held a workshop with teachers about doing just that.
We have about 20 teachers who we recruited this year from the metropolitan area to really help us co-design and co-develop engaging design activities for their students.
Each teacher designed a project and prototyped it in the workshop. The idea was that they would take it back to their classes in the fall and give it a try with their students. So a couple months into the school year, we wanted to find out how some of these projects went. This is Diane Krupin. She's a fourth grade teacher at Seacliff Elementary. Diane developed a really great project, and so we headed out to Seacliff to talk with her and some of her students about how it went.
The question that was posed to them is, how could we harness the sun's energy to heat food? And they had just certain materials that were available to them, which was a challenge to use to create their designs. And they worked through the process of first asking the question, then planning out a design, then creating that design, improving it, going through various iterations, and they came up with these.
Well, it still needs a few improvements, but we have the door. We have the little reflector, basically silver styrofoam, and then we have the glass little window so the sun can enter. And then we have the tray, and we should have made it black, so that's what we're going to do for our next prototype.
And we started with, we
started with garbage bags. And then we realized that garbage bags covering a shoebox does not work because it does not get hot inside.
So we covered it outside on the outside with black paper, and inside, although you can't see it, like behind this black paper, there's folded bubble wrap so we could insulate the heat more and like trap it.
We kind of learned how to like
work together. Better.
Kids. So, right, I mean, these are the finished products, but when we started out, they looked nothing like this. They began to experiment with the materials and to think about how they could use those materials to serve the purpose of, you know, heating up food. And they were, you know, playing with garbage bags, and they realized that the garbage bags were too shiny and were going to reflect the light, and they were learning about reflection and refraction of light, and, you know, then even started testing certain materials. And as they went through all those different iterations, they began to think about other materials that they would like to have and they would like to use for their designs. And then we collected a couple of different materials and realized that, you know, with the limitations, they could just do so much. But they actually did, you know, a lot more as they began to build on their previous designs.
Like, it's a process that helps you create like something that benefits everyday life.
You don't want to do it next test? Come on, the tests are fun.
We kind of had an idea.
Yeah,
we had an idea of what we were going to build. But
at the time
we had no clue what it was actually going to do. So like, my original idea was like way different from this.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, so we had like
the
same materials
that
we wanted to use.
But our ideas changed.
Yes. We didn't really need the coals once we thought of the rack and like the tinfoil reflecting the light up, letting heat up. So on the insulating could just like trap the heat inside, so we didn't really need the coals or fire.
I'm always looking to stretch their thinking, to work on those 21st century skills, letting them not only be create, give them opportunities to be creative, but also opportunities to communicate their learning and to show others what they created and why they created it and how it is really working towards solving real world problems.